The Great White North fights back against COVID-19. Canadian universities are front and center tackling this crisis and tracing its impact on our lives. This is Universities Fight COVID-19 from Radio Western. Each episode, we tell you about COVID-19 related research and commentary coming out of Canadian universities. Today's episode is from Western University, a program that converts emergency shelter space into long-term affordable housing is showing significant benefits for our communities most vulnerable. Now, Western researchers are pushing for additional permanent housing solutions in emergency shelters nationwide. Since 2004, London's Salvation Army Centre of Hope has provided pay-for-stay private units in a building that also offers emergency shelter. The building has 66 private transitional rooms. It is Canada's only shelter to offer such an option. Residents have reported improved overall health, self-esteem, and a sense of dignity. Western professors Abe Odshun, Carrie Marshall, and Diane Beffers interviewed 16 of these private room residents, asking them about their experiences. These interviews will help develop the program as it grows to meet the needs of new residents. It will also help better understand and improve the private room model. So far, the program has received near universal praise. Residents shared how their own rooms were so vital in helping them transition to more stable housing. The program, they say, has changed their lives, helped them manage their substance abuse, and given them safety. For $500 a month, residents get a private room in which to live, access to all services offered by the center, including meals and financial supports. They are bound by a curfew and are not allowed visitors. They're allowed to stay for up to 4 years. So why is this all important? Past research shows that getting into a shelter is better than sleeping on the street. Also, people's health and social outcomes continue to decline when they are in an emergency shelter. During the interviews, residents mentioned how their safety, their privacy, and ability to lock the door is important. People are actually getting better when they have their own space, their own bathroom, and are not worried about getting robbed or being exposed to drugs. Currently, shelters across Canada are under immense pressure to meet current emergency bed needs. Amidst this, there has not been time to focus on getting people out of shelters and into permanent housing. The researchers have put together a how-to manual for other shelters to implement affordable housing options. As Odshun notes, they have existing space and they have staff expertise. So let's push for a permanent solution instead of just shelters. This story was adapted from Paul Main's Western News article, Study Backs Shelter Space as Housing Solution.